Hi everyone. All right, so today I'm going to go ahead and show you a haul that I did from my local library's annual book sale. So today was the preview day. So if you are a member of the Friends of the Library, then you get in for free on preview day. Otherwise, if you're a non-member, it's $10 just to get in. So fortunately, my membership was good up until the end of the month. So I'm going to renew it probably maybe tomorrow or Friday, because it's $10 a year. Otherwise, you can renew it for 3 years at $25. That's a better option. So I think I'm going to go ahead and do that. That way I don't have to worry about, you know, if my membership is still good. So anyways, I usually go to these book sales because I want to get like the vintage books. And here is what I got. So just so you know, vintage books, the hardbacks are $2. And then the large and small paperbacks are either $1 and then 25 cents. So let me go ahead and show you the hardbacks that I got. I'll start with the largest one. So I immediately went to the vintage children's books. I was like the fourth person in line. So I just made a beeline over there. And I usually get books. Last year, I think I only got like 3 books and they weren't even children's vintage books. But anyways, this is the first one that I got. And the reason why I bought most of these books is because I'm going to be using them for junk journaling and for collage work. So this is Things to Make and Do, Child Horizons. And I thought it was really, really cute because the images in the book, as you can see, shows you how to make toys and stuff. And yeah, this is really, really cute. The book is pretty much intact, as you can see. So I got that. Okay, put that to the side. Next book that I got, Singing on Our Way. Okay. And this is a music book. I love this right here. I might scan it and then print it out. Actually, I might scan a lot of these instead of tearing up the book. And it's really nice. So both in black and white and color. Oh, I love those images. Okay. Then we have this one here. Now, this one is not a children's book, but it is a cookbook. So I was also right next to the section for the children's. I was in the vintage adult books. And this one, I mean, I immediately grabbed it when I saw it because it's a Betty Crocker picture cookbook. Now, it's torn up. I mean, you can see that. And somebody was trying to sell this book for $55. I got it for $2. I can't tell because it looks like they ripped out a whole section. Because look at that. That's page 22. So I have no idea how old this book is. I'm going to have to look it up. This one I will probably tear up. But I can probably scan a lot of this and then print it out. But I always like looking at these old vintage cookbooks, because it's just interesting, you know, to see how they made food back then. It's so simple. All these different types of breads, cakes. I'm not really into cakes, but and then there's dessert cookies, frostings. Oh, come on. There's got to be. There we go. Dishes. There's salads, pies, supper dishes. Yeah. Vegetables. Even though it's torn up, I still, you know, didn't mind getting this book. Then the next one I got was also in the, I want to say it was in the adult section. Maybe it was in the children's section. I can't remember. But it's The Story of America in Pictures. And it has all these old images, pictures or drawings, paintings. I'm probably going to let my nephew read this. He seems to be interested in history a lot, so he might like to look at this. I don't think I'm going to tear it up. I love history, so that's one of the reasons why I bought this book. And it goes all the way up to, we're showing all the presidents, but where does it end? Probably to the 1950s, 30s maybe, 40s, I guess. So we got that. And I got this. when I was a senior in high school, and this is going to date me, one of the subjects that I did take was shorthand. I took typing for one semester, and then I took shorthand, and man, I didn't realize how hard it was. So I don't remember doing too well in that class. But now I have the book, so I can go back and try to learn again. I think it's just really cool. It's kind of like dead nowadays, right? I don't think anyone uses shorthand now that we can just like type everything on the computer and stuff. But still, it's still kind of neat to know. It's almost like a code in a way, right? So I got that. I was looking for typing books, but they didn't have any. I do have one, but I wanted to get another one. And then this last hardback was Good Housekeeping Book of Menus and Recipes and Household Discoveries. And this one is a pretty old book, 1922. I don't have my reader, so I can't can't really see up close. And yeah, this also has like recipes. I don't think, yeah, this one does not have any pictures, but still, I thought that this would be really interesting to look at. Let's see, I don't want desserts. I'm just not a big dessert fan. Fruit combinations. Oh, that's cool. Jams and jellies and marmalades. Here we go. This is what I'm looking for. If I can find the beginning of it. Meat. Okay. Baked liver. Whoa. Beef loaf with rice. Yeah. So this I may tear up. There were a couple of other books that I had picked out, but I put them back. One in particular was this interesting German recipe book or cookbook. And I was kind of shocked because it was printed in 1952 and it was signed by the author. I looked it up and I could only find like one person selling a signed copy on Etsy. But I mean, I was tempted to get it, but at the same time I was like, I mean, I don't want to pay $2. If it's still there, like on Dollar Day, then I may get it. And then there was a couple of other books that I saw that were like printed in 18, 76 or something, or 1892. I was shocked because those are super old books. But I put them back. Yeah, like I said, I didn't want to spend too much money when the hardbacks are just $2. So these are the paperbacks that I did get. And I love collecting these golden guides. These were only 25 cents. Here, I'm going to cover where my library is at, but this is the list of prices. Okay. So you can see here. Okay. So that's Friday and Saturday. On Saturday, it's just $5 a bag. They'll give you a paper bag, you fill it up. And then the jumbo sale, it's $3 to fill up a bag. So basically, it's like what's left over. The prices do start going down. I know tomorrow is open to the public. And then I know Friday, I think the prices probably also go down. But I forgot to look to see how much they were. But anyways, so I got this one. I've had this one before, I think, the seashore one. Then I've got this one on trees, the various trees. In the US, I guess. Tropical fish. This one's on mammals. I've never seen this one before, or the tropical fish one. This one, bats. Okay, why do we need a book on bats? I'll probably tear that one up because I don't really care about bats. And then this last one here, tropical rainforest. And this was obviously in the library. And this one was really interesting too. I just love the illustrations in these books. So, yeah, so I got how many of these? Two, four, six. So, six of these for 25 cents each. Not a bad, haul, right? So, in the end, I did, this is how much I spent. So, I spent $13.50, no tax. They by the door, they also had a whole bunch of like the Reader's Digest, the compilation books or anthologies, and they were free. And they had a whole table full of them. They said, pick as many as you want. I looked at them, but I didn't get any this time. Tomorrow, I'm taking my nieces and nephew over to the book sale, and I may go ahead and buy, get some, because my bag was already heavy. And yeah, just this alone was a lot of weight. I usually bring an IKEA tote bag to carry all the books. I mean, there were people there that had like freaking carry-on bags, like luggage with on wheels, because it's just easier to just throw them in there and then, walk around and find more books. But anyways, yeah, support your local library. Look up and see when your library has a book sale, because all the money goes to the library for them to be able to purchase new books. All of these books are from people who donated. I have a ton of old romance books that one of my aunts gave me that I just haven't gotten around to reading, and I kind of don't want to because a lot of them are Western romances and I don't really care, but I'm going to go ahead and donate those and then go through a bunch of my Dollar Tree books that I bought and then, read it a couple of times, and I don't really need to keep them, so I'm just going to go ahead and donate those as well. So, yeah. So I hope you guys enjoyed my haul here, and I will see you on the next video. Bye.